Today we are going to make a simple number countdown animation using the Morph Effect in PowerPoint 2016, and I hope you will like that. Let's first take a look. This is my first video in which I am using Morph Effect for the first time, and I have not done much practice with that, and hopefully you will like that tutorial. So let's get started. So we begin with a new presentation, and I will take blank presentation, collapse the thumbnail view and change the layout to blank. Now we will draw a rounded corner rectangle, and for that I go to the insert menu, click the shapes drop down button, and here you choose the rounded corner rectangle and draw it here. From the format menu, change the size. I am going with a height of 6 inch and a width of 3.5 inches. Go to the align drop down button and align it to the center and the middle of the slide. Change the fill color. Remove the outline. Right click on an empty area of the slide and go to format background. And I am going with a solid fill of black color. Now before we go any further, if you want it to make it perfect, for that we are going to turn on guides from the view menu, and also I am turning on the ruler. If it is not already turned on, I will advise you to turn on the ruler so you can make the thing exactly in the position and with the exact sizes. Now I will draw another rectangle. This time I will use straight corner rectangle and draw it right here and check the sizes. I want to make it exact, so I am going with 2.5 inch height and 2.5 inches width. Okay, position it in the middle and the center of the slide as well, and now I am going to position it right on top of that, right here. Make a duplicate of this rectangle. You can also press Ctrl D after selecting the object to make a quick duplicate. Select the object and press Ctrl D and position it right here. Now I will add a few more guides, so when I change the numbers they remain in exact alignment and doesn't look distorted. For that, right click on one of the guides, like this horizontal guide. Make sure to turn on guides before you go with that from the view menu. Now right click on the horizontal guide and click on add horizontal guide and position it right here. Add one more and position it on the top. Same way, right click on the vertical guide and then add a vertical guide, and I will position it right here. Add one more and position it right here. Add two more. Sorry. And position them, one right here and another one here. Okay. Now fill this rectangle with black color and remove the outline. Now we have our zero. Expand the thumbnail view. Right click on the slide and click duplicate slide. And now we want to convert this 0 to 9. And for that, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to reduce the size of this bottom rectangle a little bit and make sure to check the ruler that how much size you are reducing. I am going with 2 points right here. You can see a red line in the ruler which indicate the position you are assigning to the rectangle, and I am reducing the size to 0.2, and you can check that from the format menu. Now it's 2.25, and same way I am going to do this with this rectangle. 2.25. Now what I am going to do is I am going to increase the size of this rectangle as well in the width and the height, and I think that's okay. Now create another duplicate, and this time I am going to adjust the size back to the same position right here. And if I am going to reduce the size of this rectangle just like 2.25, and I am also going to do this with the top rectangle, just reducing 0.2 inches, around 0.25 inches for both of the rectangles. Now create another duplicate and do this for all the numbers that you want to show on the screen. And for number 7, I'm going to set it right here, this one right here, and increase the width and the height of this one. And repeat these steps to create more numbers, and it is up to you that how you want the rectangles, black rectangles, to appear on the screen. For number 6, that's fine. Now it's time for number 5, and for number 5 I'm reducing it right here and expanding the width of the bottom one. Again, for number 4, I am going to increase the height of this one, reduce the width, same with here, sorry, right here and bottom right here. Now it's time for number 3, and for number 3 I will adjust it right here. This one right here, that's fine. Same way number 2, and for number 2 I'm going to adjust it. For number 2 I'm going to adjust it right here. And this one right here, that's okay. And finally number 1, and that one is easy, just increase the height of both rectangles. See, that's up to you that how you align the black rectangles, and that will create the numbers for you. It's up to you that how much accuracy you want in the numbers. Now we are going to select all these slides, and for that select one of the slide and press Ctrl A to select all the slides in the thumbnail view. Go to the transition tab, click the morph effect, and let me tell you one more thing, that you might not see morph effect in your PowerPoint 2016 or 2013, and that's because it is not available by default in the earlier versions of 2016 and 2013. And if you want to check that which version of PowerPoint you are using, for that you can go to the file menu, click the accounts button, and here you can click on the about PowerPoint, and here you can see that I have PowerPoint 2016 with a version of 16.0.8730.2046, 64 bit version, and that is an upgraded version of PowerPoint 2016. if you have Office 365 subscription, then you might see that Morph effect in your PowerPoint. Otherwise, you have to update your PowerPoint to the latest build. And you can do this by going to the File menu, Accounts, and then you can click on Office Updates. And here you can choose which option you think will be the right one for you. Mostly the Update Now button you will click to check and update your PowerPoint version. And after selecting all the slides, click on the Morph Effect once. And now tell for how much time you want to see that slide, each slide. And I would like to see each slide for 1 second. And for the morph timing, let me select all of the slides first again. And for the morph timing, I am going with 0.50, half second. Now let's see the preview. See, that was a simple trick to animate these numbers using the black rectangles. And as I told you before, that was my first presentation where I am using the morph effect, and I hope you will like that. Let me know by leaving your comments, and if you find this video useful, then you can also like it and share it with your friends. And I think this video is for beginners who want to use morph effect and want to try how that behave. And hopefully I will come up with more good tutorials using the Morph Effect. Thanks for watching and take care.